Hello and welcome to the assembly video of the Maker's Pet home robot. When this robot is finished, it will act as a pet. It will run around the house, demand the owner's attention, it will play and entertain itself and its owners, play games like chase, hide and seek, ball, to keep itself busy. So let's start with the assembly. Let's start with the base plate and mount the motors to the base plate. These are 24-volt brushless motors with the controller board inside built in. When you mount the motors, make sure that the mounting holes of the motor align with the mounting holes of the base plate. Use M3 5mm screws to mount the motor. All parts have been printed from PLA. The bumper and the head were printed from silk PLA in particular. Now let's mount the motor brackets on top of the motors. Mind the orientation of the motor bracket. If the orientation is incorrect, the mounting holes will not match to the base plate. The motor brackets use 4 M3 20mm long screws. Keep in mind that when you drive those M3 screws into the plastic for the first time, there is no thread in the mounting hole, so it will take a little extra effort to drive those screws into the plastic. Just be patient and keep applying some pressure, and the friction from the screw turning inside the plastic hole will start melting the plastic, and this is the way the thread will form. Make sure there is no gap between the motor bracket and the base plate. Alright, now it's time to mount the wheels. Take a look at the wheel and find the shaft screw. Align the shaft screw with the flat part of the motor's shaft. Put the wheel onto the motor shaft, and now you can tighten the screw. And do the same with the second wheel. These are 65mm wheels. Next, let's assemble the battery compartment. Here you will need 4 M3 screws, 6mm long. Okay, looking good. Now let's assemble the caster wheel. Take the steel shaft and insert it into the caster wheel and drop the caster wheel with the shaft into the caster wheel opening in the base plate. Make sure the wheel spins nicely. Now fix the caster wheel in place by inserting the battery box. All you have to do is slide the box in. Now let's put 3 9-volt batteries into the battery box. It is possible to use a rechargeable battery, but for now, let's keep it simple and let's use 3 9-volt batteries connected in series as our power supply. Mind the orientation of the battery box lid. The tiny notches on the battery box lid should be facing down. The reason we can use these batteries is because this robot runs on an ESP32 microcontroller that consumes very little power compared, say, to a Raspberry Pi. Well, great, now we can proceed with mounting the laser scanner. Place the laser distance scanner on the carrier plate. Orient the laser distance scanner so that the motor fits into the motor hole of the carrier plate. Now mount the scanner using four M2.5 5mm screws. Again, as you try driving the screws into the plastic that doesn't have a thread, just keep applying pressure and be patient and make a few turns, maybe half a dozen turns, maybe a dozen turns, until the thread starts forming. This is the middle plate. This plate carries the laser distance scanner. There is a notch in the middle plate that should match the notch in the carrier plate of the laser distance scanner. Now slide the carrier plate with the laser distance scanner into the middle plate. Until the notches align and click in place. The notches make sure that the laser distance scanner is positioned exactly in the middle of the middle plate. Now we can proceed with assembling the bumper. Now you have to orient the middle plate so the columns of the middle plate fit into those little gaps in the bumper. It is convenient to assemble this component upside down. Now let's drive four M3 screws into the bumper holes. And now let's repeat the same with the other half of the bumper. Alright, let's go back to the base plate and put in some electronics. This board is a breakout board for the ESP32 microcontroller running Arduino. There are two small connectors. Those connectors go into the motors. Make sure that the connector orientation is correct. In this video, the electronics board is a breadboard. I will be replacing it shortly with a proper PCB that will be mounted inside the robot's body. This is the power connector. For now, we will leave it unconnected. And this is the connector that goes to the laser distance scanner. We will connect it a little later. Now let's mount the middle plate on top of the base plate. Make sure that the motor of the laser distance sensor faces toward the battery box. Just take the middle plate and slide it with the bumper onto the base plate. Make sure that the wires don't get pinched. Now you can secure the bumper using four M3 screws on each side. These are 4mm flathead screws. Now we can plug in the laser distance scanner. Mind the connector orientation. Well, great! Now it's time to assemble the head of the robot. This is the upper plate. It just got printed. Let's take it off the build plate. place the upper plate on top of the columns sticking up from the middle plate, and use 4 M3 screws to secure the upper plate. These are 6mm flathead screws. Now the head gets mounted without screws. Place the head on the upper plate and make sure the front gets hooked to the rail in the middle of the upper plate. Now all you have to do is push slightly on the face of the head to make the back of the head latch in place. Now let's add the footrest for the smartphone. The footrest has tabs that go into the larger openings in the upper plate. Just snap the footrest bar into place like this. Now you can slide the footrest bar to adjust its position to your handset. Now the handset clamp latches into the upper slots. I had to clean one of the upper slots to get some strenuous piece of plastic out. The robot's head is designed to accommodate a 40mm fan behind the handset. For now, let's ignore the fan. It will be connected at a later time. This is an old Galaxy S8. Adjust the upper clamp and the footrest to make sure that the handset stays in place. Great! Congratulations, you've assembled your home robot.